I am Ola Onsrud, reenacting an early 13th century Norwegian knight, or a Skutilsvein, which is the corresponding Norwegian title at the time. That puts me in the second half of the Norwegian Civil War period that lasted from 1130 to 1240. I could be one of King Sverre's knights, the usurper king whose descendants emerged as victorious in the Civil War. In this video, I want to talk about perhaps the most important weapon beside the spear in Nordic medieval times. Before showing you my 13th century battle axe, I have dismounted, since this seems primarily to be a weapon used on foot. The battle axe is an effective short-range weapon available for a relative low cost compared to a sword, which made it more common among ordinary troops and lower Norwegian nobility. This axe is based on a find in Vorma, a river in southeast Norway, flowing from Lake Mjøsa into the river Glomma. Today, it is in the Cultural Historic Museum in Oslo and is one of a few finds with a preserved haft or handle. That's about 110 centimeters long. The head of the axe has been forged by Anders Helseth, who is both an armorer and a blacksmith, and a historian working with the Viking and medieval period. The haft of the original axe is made by spurs, but I have chosen to use white birch, which is harder and stronger. First, I make a template showing the cross section of the axe haft, which I will use when cutting and planning the haft. Battle axe is a powerful weapon. This piece of wood, dressed in linen, simulates the thickness of a shield. In a combat situation, however, this will not be as easy, because the opponent moves and can slash or stab back. So I have to use one hand handling my shield and to protect myself, and therefore I have only one hand left for wielding the axe. This is my brother Per. He's going to help me demonstrate. In Norway, however, the battle axe is more than just a weapon. It's also a symbol of eternal kingship.
This is Sankt Olav on an altarpiece from around 1300. As in most illustrations of the saint and the eternal king of Norway, he is carrying an axe. The altarpiece also showed the king's death at the Battle of Stiklestad in 1030. According to Snorre's saga, however, the king was cut down by Kalv Arneson. This way, an axe became the symbol of St. Olav and the first used by the Archbishop of Nidaros and later by the Church of Norway. In the 13th century, St. Olav's axe also became a part of the Norwegian royal coat of arms.
As far as I interpret the historical sources, and also based on my own experience, I believe that this type of axe is primarily a weapon for foot. Far more unbalanced and heavy forward than the sword, I would be very afraid to injure the horse using this on horseback.